What's going on, dudes, boys and girls, friends and viewers, people who I do know and those I still do not. My name is Kolosalus. Welcome back to another Heroes of Storm video. And today I'm doing something a little different. A lot of the questions I'm getting on my videos is how do I improve as a player? Not me personally, but how the person asking improves as a player. And I really wanted to address that in this video. So this is both kind of like how I improve myself, how I try to improve at least, and how I know that improving actually works. And second of all, I had this very, very good game with Zeratul, and I just want to share with you guys, along with kind of like analysis, what I did, what I did. And this is also a game with a singularity spike talent. So it's a little bit unconventional. People like to go for straight up auto attack, you know, with the wormhole. But so there you go. I'm gonna play it here. You can see I'm here. It's a Hero League match, by the way. The enemy team, you know, I picked up Zeratul to really counter Nazebo and the Chromie. I know that I know 100% that Artanis can be a very, very huge deal to me if I use my blink, but the biggest the biggest kind of a threat to me is this, the hacker right here. So I know that this guy cannot do too much to me, and he's actually going to pick up seven-sided to counter me, to counter my ganks, to counter me trying to push out this Chromie. But it's actually pretty funny. Level one, we did go for a Vorpal Blade. Again, we are going to go into this this initial brawl first, but look at my positioning here. I'm not in the fight. I'm trying to circle around. I'm trying to kind of maybe even actually go in here would have been better, just because I mean, you know, I would have been closer to a fight, maybe been able to do some stuff, but I was safe, and I actually got right here. Our team is in a lot of trouble right now, but so is the enemy team. The enemy team is standing in the blizzard, in the root, which means they'll be taking a lot of damage. So let's see how this plays out. I'm actually right here. I'm going to be closing in on the enemy team. So I come in, use a couple of my abilities. Now I blink back with my Vorpal Blade and I finish off the enemy Karazim. Very, very easy, kind of like a textbook play from just a normal Zeratul player. Now, when there's nothing to do, I know that we've already finished the middle brawl, right? We already finished the middle brawl, and we are going to start losing XP in the top. I automatically go from here to here, and we basically start the laning phase. We start the laning phase, but notice what I do here. I kill the front line, and then I leave the rest, and I kind of just mount up and just wait in the bush. What this does is, if any of my minions die right now, the enemy team will not have XP. They will not gain XP for that minion. So I don't want to kill this minion and basically push it onto the towers. I want to just kill the front line, just so my team, my wave still wins, but I still want to make the enemy team lose XP. So there we go. Let's play this out a little bit faster. So now they lost about half of the XP. So they lost about this XP. They got the XP for the last minion. Now I'm wondering, you know, where's the hacker? I was actually wondering in the game, where's the hacker? Where is he right now? Well, he was actually waiting for me right here. He saw me coming, and it's going to be going to result in a little bit of a brawl between us. I know that I'm not supposed to be afraid. I'm just supposed to be careful. If there's any help coming from middle, again, at the time I did not see anybody come from middle, and I knew I saw. I'm seeing Chromie and this. I'm not seeing Karazim. Karazim is not a strong gank hero, so I'm pretty safe in the top lane. Plays faster. Again, this is just a just normal like just laning. I'm actually gonna get into the bush to get any XP that I will be missing. Now I'll tag the wave. Here's another engagement with me and the hacker. I can actually do something here, but I make him use his only kind of like essence. So here I'm actually baiting him into thinking that I'm actually backing. So into thinking that he should push up this lane. He should not leave these minions, or maybe at least back up. Push up the same, because I'm gonna lose all this XP. But look what I do. So I'm Ali. So he backs up. He doesn't see me anymore. And there we go. I'm gonna move in here for the clear. and then maybe actually move out. But then I feel like I can pressure him. I can still pressure him, even though my low XP, I can still kind of know when he's going to use his tongue. So I'm going to come in here, show him that I'm here, get out, get back in, and try to finish him off. But I know that I can't, so I'm just staying safe, getting away from the fight. And I give a vision of our team that he is low. Well, he's going to back up again. Again, our team doesn't want to do anything with it. It looks like they're busy down in here. I'm going to increase the speed right here, so we're not going to sit here for the full half an hour. But here, as soon as I'm back, with the team. I see that there's only Nazebo here, and I saw that Chromie is here, and I heard the Haka burrowing somewhere here, or actually, I might have not even heard them, which means that he either didn't use it, or he used it far away. So he's either walking, or he's not even close to us. So again, I'm gonna come in here, and I'm gonna, what I do, I know this is a kill. This is 100% kill. This guy just used a teleport, but I believe in my team that they're gonna basically follow up on what I do. So I'm here. They see, actually Malfurion comes in. I use all of my skills here and actually do get some healing. There was a very nice root by our friendly Malfurion. I think that would have been a kill anyway. The root was there just to add the insult to the injury, and we are able to pick up a kill. So we're gonna go back to laning, going back to get XP. Very, very important. Now we are moving up because the enemy team still hasn't finished their immortal. So I go through the portal here. Probably a very, very bad play because I lost health for no reason. I basically got hit by the abilities from the enemy Chromie, and you can see that it was actually my fault for going through. I should have probably went around this way, trying to flank Chromie, because look how low she is, and she is singled out. We are here trying to kind of like kill the Haka, and I think we do or we don't. No, we don't. I don't think we don't actually kill him here. But you can see we are losing time on killing these guys. Actually, I think we might be able to pick up a kill here. We are losing time on here where we would have already killed Chromie. So again, that's my mistake. I went through the portal to go kind of in the fight, but I should have just went around this way. I knew they were doing this, so come here and try to surprise this Chromie. It was my bad. So that's how I learned. That's how I know that I messed up. So we do get a kill here on the enemy Karazin, but we trade one for one, which is a terrible trade. It's a terrible trade. You should never trade, I guess those are two priority targets, so it's fine to trade, but you should always try to get a kill. I'm not sure why our Malfurion was positioning in such a way he was positioning, but again, I'm worrying about the things I control. Today, like basically here, we're just going to back. There's nothing here else to do, so what we're going to do, go back to lanes. Go back to soak XP. XP is one of the most important things in the game. So again, we're going to come in here, maybe try to apply some pressure to this... this is the Haka, but again, all we're doing is getting XP and trying to control them up. We are controlling the vision. We know who's going this way. We know that Chromie is here because of Medivh. This is very important. This is very, very important. I saw that she was going to rotate right here. I saw her riding on a horse, so it was an easy gank for me. That's why you want to control the vision, the map control. I know that we have to get a pick because we are a little bit down on levels and we need to get on level 7, and this is a perfect opportunity. This is also a very, very good play by our Medivh here. He sees that she just used her W, so if I play this out, I'm going to get a protect just in time. I'm going to blink in for the kill. Just a very, very easy kill. I was also not afraid because I saw the Haka still in the middle. So I was not afraid to actually blink in, and I wasn't afraid of the actual tongue hitting me. So let's play this out again. Again, just controlling the map. This should allow you guys, again, this is another... So again, I hope this video helps you how to play Zeratul, but also how to kind of play this map. This map is very, very important because it's actually one of the prominent maps in the meta right now, in the actual rotation. I see it much more. This is a potential kill. I see that he is slowed by her trait. If he wasn't and he was actually full health, I would not engage in it. I would maybe poke him and get away. But I know this is a kill. I 100% know this is a kill because we also have Medivh right behind me. So this is a 3v1 gank situation. I'm going straight for the kill with my newly picked up Seeker in the Dark. I can basically teleport to whoever I hit with a W. I hit a W, I teleport almost right back in, use my Q and then use my combo slash to get as much ability damage and other attack to weave in the damage as I can. And that's another kill. That's another gank kill. The enemy team cannot do anything right now. So again, I'm just going to roam again. I do encourage my team right here. Good job, good job. It's a very important thing to do. It's a very small thing, but it's a very important. I do miss the singularity spike for a potential, not a kill, but really kind of like a harass on the enemy Dahaka here. We're still going to harass him, I think. But it's not going to result in anything big. Of course, clearing out the camp, very, very important. I know that he's not in danger, so I'm just going to rotate. I'm getting the fuck out. But I want to help our Varian. Right when I was here, when I was clearing the camp, I knew I had to rotate top because I saw Varian soloing this lane. I knew he was in trouble from Karazim and Artanis. So I come in here, and I kind of like basically feel out the situation. What's the situation? He's already making the mistake of actually making it apparent that he's overextending because somebody else is here. So they start to play a little bit more cautious. You can see Artanis starting to back, and I engage on him, but I want to try to take, basically attack Artanis so Karazim feels bad to leave him because he's a healer. So you can see he doesn't leave. I switch my target. I jump in for the kill on the Karazim, and you can see that the Artanis is still out of position. I'm not sure if we're actually going to kill him here. I know that I won't be healed with her abilities here. Let's see. Are we going to pick up a kill? No, it looks like we won't be picking up a kill. It looks like the friendly team still wants to brawl, but I think at this time I was already heading down to the middle for some more XP. Yeah, I basically pinged there that we need to retreat, and there's no reason to fight. So I'm going to actually try to harass this the hacker here. And again, just playing the kind of a Dark Seeker, Dark Templar gameplay, where I'm here and I'm not, you know, in split seconds. So again, just kind of, I know we just made him use his essence. That's one of the most important things you can pull out of the Haka, is his full essence. He used his full essence to heal for about half health right there, which is super huge for us. And then he still stays. He's gonna be hit with a stun here. He's gonna be hit with all the ability damage. I'm gonna blink in with my Seeker of the Dark, but we won't be able to secure a kill. And what he has to do now, he has to back, and if he wants to contest the objective, he has to burrow back. So we used the essence and we used the burrow. That's basically why kind of ganking with Zeratul is so important, because you can pull out stuff out of people, especially in Hero League, where they don't basically pay as much attention to details as the pros. So we're gonna come here. I know I'm on low on mana. I'm gonna just tap, even though I'm high on health. That's what kind of a normal play. There's a kill on Nazebo. I wasn't even needed there, but I still kind of I'm here waiting maybe for the help. You see, I'm giving vision to my team that maybe somebody's coming. Maybe we can get another kill, or we should back off. Again, I'm just kind of positioning again for the seeds, so we get the seeds. I know that the genius has got this. I know I walked into it. I'm a noob. But we finished this plant, and straight away you see me. I know I'm going for the garden terror. I know I'm going for it because I'm the slippiest person on our team, and honestly, I think I should be the only one going for it, because again, I'm not needed in a team fight. Because Jaina is enough damage, Varian is enough of a taunt. We have a healer and also some damage mixed with some damage mitigation. So I'm not needed in the fight if one breaks out. So I immediately know that I need to back. So I back, even though I'm full health, full mana. I don't even wait a single second. I don't think you should wait a single second for to back for your first turn. The other ones you can actually hold. It's good to hold them for the rest of the team to come back. The enemy team is obviously doing this, but they're split. We know that Chromie is trying to poke at us here, and we know that Nazebo, we see Nazebo in the middle. So we potentially know that we could do something about this. Also, one mistake I made is I did not rotate to defenders, and we are actually going to lose top very, very easily soon. So we're going to play this out. I'm going to back off. It's also very, very important to let your team know what heroic you pick. I picked the Void Prison because it, you know, it synergizes with the Ring of Frost. We could catch some very, very important combos. Could be nice Twilight Dream as well. Leyline Seal, of course. I'm not sure about Leyline Seal here, but he picked it. So it actually ends up working. So why is it not following? There we go. So I'm the Garden Terror. The friendly team is brawling, but this is fine because the enemy team is missing two people because Nazebo fell in the middle because he was basically taken out. He was ganked. He was out of position, and they also have one person here. So it's a 4v3. So I'm fine with them fighting right there. Jaina a little bit out of position here. I'm not sure if she's gonna actually make it. The Twilight Dream that you just used there, but you see again. This is getting huge value, and this is definitely a fort for the enemy team, especially like even if we now rotate. I did type death top, but looks like this guy's already gone top, so we already know top is gone. Top is like nowhere near. So I'm just gonna go bottom. I know that the teams are brawling in the middle, so I know I'm gonna have a free push bottom. So that's what I do. I just push down fort. The enemy team does get the top fort, and now the friendly team starts to rotate to defend, which is honestly a little bit too late. So I'm here. I just kind of, you know, just kind of like basically rotating now. Just kind of taking the time from the enemy team, trying to soak as much damage as I can. Here's the mistake I make. My only death in the game. I get out of the terror. As I was pressing E, I got temporal looped. As soon as I got out of the terror, I was temporal looped. And I pressed my E, which means that I used my escape right before, right after the actual temporal loop popped. So this is a very, very, there's a very big chance that I'm actually gonna die here. So what should have I done here is not panic, not E away, but stay in here. That would have made him miss his face prism, and actually use my void prism on Chromie so I mitigate most of the damage. Instead, I just get picked off here, and I also waste my void prism. And the friendly team does get kind of baited into fighting in 4v5. We do pick up a kill on the Haka though, so it's not too bad. But again, this is just my mistake. I should have been much more cautious and much, basically not panic as much. And enemy Artan is trying to go for the swaps. Karazim out of position, this is just a perfect use of everything. But now we're actually getting payload. Yeah, the enemy, it looks like the Haka just kind of coming into the fight fully healed. And this is what actually going to break the team fight for us. Also the Haka here picking up a kill on the from the friendly medieval, but this is actually very important what's going to happen here. I know that these two are low. This is not my target right now. Even though she's a squishy, she is not my target. I want this guy. I want him right now. I know he just uses essence and it gave him almost nothing. So I'm pretty sure I can definitely kill him right here. So what I do, I just wait up until I cloak, just to not give them vision. It looks like I still see the Haka here. I still see the Haka here fighting. So I'm just gonna rotate. She just messed up by actually placing it again, because if she would have left it there, she would have basically enabled the Haka to either escape or to catch me with a tongue when I was actually, you know, like in the actual time trap. But rather she messes up and I'm able to just get a W, teleport back, and also get a very nice kill, and I do get some applause for my medivh. So again, but I only pick up one kill, but one kill is enough, again, especially after a fight when we are going into a phase where nothing is happening. You know, it's basically the phase of the camps. It's very important to pick up a kill just so you have advantage. Here, very, very important rotation. We know they're going to be doing this camp. We know because it's a phase of doing camps. We know that Nazebo is probably going to do it alone because we didn't have vision of Chromie. But we did have vision of Artanis down below, and we did just see that they picked up a camp here. So we know that two people are here. We just don't know where Chromie is. So Chromie is not that big of a deal. She does have her temporal her temporal loop now. But I'm the first one here, so I'm just going to try to harass this this Nazeba as much as I can. And just because the enemy Artanis did not rotate, he did not help his Nazeebo, it's going to be an easy kill. I know I have the temporal loop on me, but I don't really care. Frankly, I just don't give a shit. She's right here trying to do her damage. And she's going to do it. She's going to do damage, but I know she can't kill me. She can't kill me from full health. Now I'm just going to dodge. I know she's going to be trying to hit her here, so I just dodge the other way. Very, very easy. Kind of like, you know, just kind of normal stuff when playing against the Chromie. Now I can just kind of go back here to ensure that we are going to get this objective. And now again, just focusing on the objective. Objectives are very, very undervalued in this on this objective. And we are get another terror, and straight away I rotate to get it. Very, very important play right here. Very, very important play. So we get into the terror. We see that the friendly team is fighting, so I want to help them now. Rather than actually split pushing, I know that I'm probably going to get pushed out by this guy, so I don't want to 1v1 him. I want to make this a 4v5, but Varian's actually all singled out. He is in a lot of trouble. So we're going to come in here. Very nice Leyline Seal secures us the victory, but a very nice combo. I'm able to place down my Q, my polymorphing flower, under the lane line seal, and we're able to pick up a kill here on the enemy Artanis. Enemy Dehaka also falls, and I now have a free push going up here. These guys are still brawling. They want to get this kill on the enemy Chromie. And honestly, it's not a bad idea, just because I do the flower pops down, and we can actually start rotating. So we see that the friendly team is rotating. The stasis will not stop his charge. The enemy Nazeebo closes his Chromie with Varian, and she's going to be taken out. Very, very easy, very, very fort for us. And honestly, XP and just kills overall. Nobody saw this up until very late, and we are actually getting pushed out right now. Like our Varian is actually a little bit of trouble. Very, very nice stun here. I'm gonna get stunned, but I'm gonna be fine. The enemy Chromie is nowhere to be found. Here I was silenced. I was hit with the isolation, and I started pinging like shit, and I started panicking. So I just popped down this. I know that the only person in it would be Jaina, so I cancel it straight away so she can make her escape. That was my bad. Again, I used the ultimate for nothing. I knew that my team was around me, and I just used it anyway. Now, again, I give vision to my friendly team. I kind of give a vision of the rotation. This actually might allow us to potentially kill Nazeebo and potentially kill this Karazim. I give them vision that their team is not even anywhere close. We close up on this Karazim, pick up an easy kill. Again, just giving vision. Who do we kill right here? Nazeebo. Nazeebo again being caught out of position. Again, I'm just gonna go back just so you guys can see that kind of how that played out. It's very, very important that you go over every single important play, every single key play. Key play being a kill, being an objective, kind of stuff like that. So again, he's just out of position. He was caught by our teleport. Our Varian did not even use his E to go into it. I'm gonna get hit by the damage, but honestly, it's just not a big damage, just because I know, I checked talents, and I know she went for Q, not the W, so I know her W is not gonna deal that much damage, unless I'm caught in the middle. I think she was trying to hit somebody else, that's why I didn't really mind getting even hit. Here, I know that we have numbers, and we should be pushing. We should be punishing the enemy team for not having people. We should be, we only see Chromie. We only know Chromie is here. I think we know that the tanks are somewhere, but the healer and their pusher are out of here. So we should be pushing. We should be doing everything in our power. So I'm getting a tower here and then moving on straight onto the fort. Honestly, this is a mistake. I should have just mounted up, went into invisibility, and tried to pressure this Chromie. I didn't do that. That was my mistake. I rather went for the siege damage and trying to get the keep, which I guess is still an okay play, but I think going for the Chromie kill here is actually not kill, but kind of harass is better. So you see, we get it down to half health, and again, I'm just staying here. I'm not showing myself. I was standing right here, just kind of trying to be the lurker. I know this is still a 4v5. I know that there's a fort here, but I do know that we do have a lane 9 seal to close it down. If we need it, of course. I do not know Zebo just spawned, so he's not going to be in a fight for another good 10 to 20 seconds. So we can definitely go into this. So I use my singularity spike to engage here. I do teleport right to him. We do pick up a kill. No, we didn't pick up a kill. We actually lost our Jaina because she did overextend a little bit. And also she was caught by the crummy damage. And also now our friendly variant is a little bit of trouble. Very, very nice. Oh, he used his protect way too early. He's going to be taken out, I believe. I'm trying to kill this Chromie, and honestly, well, not kill her, but really to make her back up, just so she doesn't kill deal damage. But she just keeps going. She just keeps going. She wants to go for a very nice dodge here. It's gonna secure the escape. But I'm here, still circling. I'm still circling. I know that Chromie was left at half health when I last poked her, even less than half health. But I do see her now, and I see that she is full health, but I'm still here. I'm still giving vision. Maybe they'll be rotating. I'm just contemplating if I should engage on the enemy Chromie, but they do stay bunched up, so I just kind of try to blend in even more than already with invisibility. I'm just gonna stay here. I'm basically waiting for them to split, and I see that the enemy team does split. And I know that they will be going for seeds. I know that 100% they'll be going for seeds. But rather than that, what I also see is that we have a 3-man versus 1 right here. And we also have a Medivh closing in. And we also have a Malfurion closing in. With both of those, I will be very useful. And I see. I just saw her use abilities. I just got vision of her. Which means that I can engage and not get a kill, but at least also harass. And maybe secure a kill. So I do blink in, as in like use my secret in the dark. Now I'm actually, there you go. So he picked up just for me, and he just forced me to get out. And I just have to, there's no other reason. You can also see the hacker basically closing in on me straight away. He wants to peel for his Chromie. Very, very good play, but just doesn't pay. I do get hit by the Q here, but I will be fine. I'd not back just because I know the Malfurion heals are enough to actually get me through. But I still see brawling. I still see that we are brawling, and I honestly don't think this is a good fight because our two main targets are here, and Varian is split from our friendly team. And the only person who is here to support him is the Medivh. So here's a blind. The silence does miss, and what am I doing? I'm just trying to again give vision to the friendly team. I know that Chromie is alone, so I straight away. Go on to that Chromie. We do pick up a kill on the enemy Chromie, but we basically make it a 1-for-1. Make it 1-for-1. Let's see what we can do else here. I am going back on their enemy team. Again, attacking Nazebo. I'm focusing Nazebo as hard as I possibly can. I know I can get this kill. I 100% know I can get this kill. Again, what you saw there is I attach my W to him and start making my way this way. So I'm going to juke Artanis. So Artanis will basically try to kill me because I didn't have much health. So I attach my W, he didn't see it. I started walking this way and I teleport with my Seeker in the Dark to secure the kill and also use my E then afterwards, my blink, my actual blink, to get away from the fight and get away 100%. Now, I start to back here. I start to back, but I know this is a 2v2, and I can definitely put the fight in our favor, especially when they're silenced and rooted. If I just come in here and receive, especially I received just a heal, which was a life seed from our friendly Malfurion, I think so. Yes, there you go, there's a life seed. Malfurion does fall, but we end up picking up the kill on the hacker. So it's a 1-for-1, but I use this right here as kind of mean of waiting for my cooldowns. I needed to get my Q, get my W to secure this 100% kill. So there we go. I try to use my burst, and we do get all the damage onto him. And now it's just back in time. I'm just going to go back, get mana, just standard stuff. Seeds are actually laying here, but looks like the friendly team does want to go for the golem. I do agree, and we are doing the golem. Zeratul, very, very good character on the golem, just because he can heal himself. Here, I'm just trying to defend, but I already know that we have a terror, but I'm not going to pick it up. I want the enemy team to waste theirs, so we're gonna have advantage when going into the actual our phase. So again. Just here, kind of, again, flanking. I want to harass this Chromie as much as I possibly can. So, let's see. I see that there's a lane line seal right there. I do fall into the time trap, which kind of slows me down. But I'm going to be on this Chromie straight away. The enemy team collapses on me. They use the heroics and they also use the gap close. And I'm fine. They use the heroic and use the gap close and I'm fine. I can just use my disengage here and just get away. Not sure why she didn't use the temporal loop, but I just got out safely and I wasted a lot of their value. So it's a value of trade. You know, it's a trade of values. And again, I'm not going to back. I see that the friendly team still wants to engage here, so I'm fine with them. I'm really, really fine with them. Medivh giving us vision. We do see the enemy team still doing it, but we did also see this Nazebo. Now, when I actually see that we cannot do too much anymore, I do go for the Terror. And I start pushing this down. I just said to my team that I want to go bottom, and I will do that. I want to get the bottom keep to get it pushing, get the catapults. I see that the only person going is the Hacker, and I see that he's actually he has his attention on Jaina. This is probably Jaina's death. She's probably dead because she doesn't see him anymore. But and we this is also probably gonna be a kill on a couple of these two. But again, I want to get a keep. This is not a team fighting tool. This is a pushing tool. So I'm getting the wall. Looks like actually I did take enough attention away from our the Hacker, so he actually let go of our Jaina. And I'm just getting value here. I'm getting value. Again, his stun's not going to do too much. I'm going to try to get this fort. I do get it, and now I'm bailing. I see that my team just all fell. I think they stayed and tried to fight. Jaina was very low, so it's no wonder she actually died, but... Yeah, so I'm just trying to, again, buy some time. I'm buying time with the polymorphic flowers. I'm just trying to run away. The enemy team is, for some reason, chasing me. I'm right here. They're still chasing me. Yeah, and they just can't do too much. I'm going to try to defend this with the flower. Again, trying to use it to its full potential. I do get taken out of it. I'm going to mount up, wait basically for my invisibility. And I'm going to try to make some plays. So I do come here. I know... The enemy Chromie is right here. The tanks are kind of focused on Medivh. They're trying to take out Medivh because he's a priority target. So I know that they're far away from me. And they're trying to reveal me right here. I think they saw me right here as well. But look, just because I'm giving vision, I see that the enemy Karazim is making a huge mistake. He is... Nazebo is here. We just saw him kill our push. We actually do get this push as well, but we just saw him kill our push. So we see that it's a 4v5. He makes a huge mistake of going for a camp. So he starts going for a camp, not expecting anybody to have vision on him from our team. Their team is backing. This guy's mounted, this guy's this way, and she is poking away so she dismounts anybody who tries to chase. I give basically the heads up that Karazim is here and this is an easy pick. So I do engage with my W. I come in here, do all the damage that I can. He does use his ultimate, which is we get a kill and the ultimate, which is just a double value. And we do anyway pick up a kill and we have an easier camp. And again, now it's a 4v5. We can honestly just own the map right now. I did not expect them to do this camp. Looks like they just did it. But what I want to do is I want to push. I want to push the shit out of this. Not sure why I attacked the wall there, probably just to kind of maybe deny them vision. I'm not sure what the actual thinking was. And I'm just trying to do something. I'm just kind of like lingering around, trying to see what I can do to help my team. For now, I'm getting vision. I see that the enemy Artanis is out of position. So what I do here, I think, is a mistake. What I do is I should have blinked in and basically got a clean void prison right here. And let us kill the tanks. What I do instead is void prison the tanks and move on to the enemy backline. So you see the void prison coming down, which is going to shut down also the damage from Chromie, which is good, right? Because you see, and I immediately move in on the backline. I'm here. I do miss everything, but I know she doesn't have her W because she just used it, and I'm out of there. But by doing this, I also split their attention. Their attention is on me rather than on killing our frontline who is fighting with their frontline, which is basically a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, versus 2. Whereas I do have my my 1 versus 2, of course, but I also have Medivh right here. And also their charism isn't here. So this is a very good fight for us. We do pick up a kill here on the enemy, the Haka, and our Tannis does fall as well. I do make my way away. I am protected, and I did receive a lot of damage. I'm just going to blink out, almost get killed, but I do blink out, and I'm definitely now going to be, just because I just don't have the health. So there we go. The friendly team just trying to do something here. They want to get this because the enemy they know that the enemy team will be rotating that way. And I agree. And we actually do get vision of them right up here. And this is actually should be a very, very easy kill for us. We do blink in for a couple of kills here. I do focus on the enemy Nazebo. It's going to be a kill. One. And then now also a full team wipe. So while I was actually taking out Nazebo, and I did get some damage back on their tank, on their Artanis. No Artanis, back on their Karazim. And on their healer. I just decided to kind of like focus their pusher just to get this guy out of the fight. And also Chromie staying a little bit too much does get taken up by our teleport and my blink. So there we go. That's how you clean up a fight. And now we honestly, this is a win. Like we have a very strong push going here. We have a healer. We have a very, very strong support specialist. We should clean up the fort, and we should move in for the win. And that's honestly what we do. I did juke this guy out of the silence. The silence maybe might have done something, but again, it's a 2v5 at this moment. At this point, we do get a lot of sustain, and I don't think there's anything they can do. And there we go, very nice silence. That's also secure kill, and this is now going to be GG for sure. You see my GG coming in, and that's game. We do finish very, very nicely at the top. Zeratul, basically a very, very tricky character to get good with, but also one with which kind of also allows you to play a bit more recklessly because of his E. You never want to use his blink to get out of the fight, into the fight. You unless you know you can pick up a kill and you know you'll be safe after. You always want to keep it for the disengage. This is just kind of like a 1-on-1 Zeratul right now. But most of the time, what you want to do is give vision, control the map, gank in the early game. That's just a perfect example. What I know I have to work on is my placement of my Void Prison. Void Prisons are very, very important. And I know I messed up a couple of them. So, again, hope you guys enjoyed. This is how I improve in Heroes of the Storm. This is how I kind of go over both losses and wins. But what I wanted to record is to kind of show you how I do it, and also show you this game, how you can improve with Zeratul and how to play him competitively in Hero League. So, hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please hit that like button if you haven't already subscribed to the channel. As always, I'll see you guys in the next one.